Morning, students.
Good morning, sir.
You know, long time. Shantan, is like long time I hear from you.
Yeah, just last week you hear from me.
No, it's only like 3 weeks.
3 weeks?
Yeah, a long time I hear the voice. Yeah. It's sound even longer too. Even though.
Yes, I am.
You not work today?
Yes, I'm going to work today, but I will do it in the afternoon.
Okay, great. Mm-hmm. All right, so you know, say, all right, I'll give you the rest of you a little time to come in because I'm seeing only six. Last week, Friday, I had class.
Mm-hmm. Friday, I had to go to work early, and then Saturday morning, okay. I had to go in.
Oh, wow. Well, say no, so people like, you know, no option for fail, you know, because you have to go find a different work.
I tell you.
Trust me, it's rough, man. It's rough. Steffi, how you do? Mornings?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. I am good. The hearing.
All right, do me a favor, somebody. Naomi just called a while ago. Sorry about that. She said she don't have the link. Can somebody just circulate the link in the chat, in the group for me, please? In the WhatsApp group, please. And I will just give the rest of you some time, the rest of the others some time to come in. Those of you who are here, see if you can log on and cover some more work on Edith, please. Time will run out. All right?
Question. All right, so when I do the work, it keeps saying resume.
Okay, let me explain that. So when you do the homework, the homework gives you five chances. You have five chances for the homework. So if when you do the homework and get 100% and say resume, you don't need to do it over because it gives five chances. So if it's 100%, you don't need to do it over. You can move on. But if you do it one time and say 40%, it gives you four other times. So you'll always see the resume button there until you do it the fifth time. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but 100%, you don't have to do over not. You just move on to the other one.
Oh, okay.
All right then, cool. Let the man them stop come class now. Go on a 10 hours so far. I am not on it because Christoph. All right. I soon talk to Christoph. All right. I'm going to start. This is me waiting half an hour for the rest of the students. Let me share something with you. I really hope that you are well. I really hope that you have been doing some work and getting yourself sorted out for exams coming up in January 2023, God's willing. One of the things that I have been observing even before last week and even before last week, Friday, last week, Saturday, I've been observing and I understand. I don't want anybody to get off at me. I understand. I know some of my students here work. They have communicated to me. I have recordings with them saying, boy, sir, I have to leave to go to work. But there are others who don't work on a Saturday morning and either not joining class or joining class very late. It is concerning. If I were to be very frank and honest with you, it is concerning. The Foundation 1 syllabus is very long. And when I go to meetings and I'm saying, boy, the online is good enough because it really helps those students who are working and can't get to come to school. You know, sometimes they can put in an earpiece. I have a student who will say to me, sir, I am at work. At the start of each class, the student declares, sir, I'm at work. If you call upon me, sir, I can't do it because my supervisor is over me. And I can understand sometimes, and let me tell you how we facilitate students. And I know I'm being recorded and anybody want to report me, that's fine. But it's only working in some organizations and they've no one giving a time off to go work. I will facilitate you. If it means I'm teaching upon Sunday, I will do it. Because the man them don't want to upgrade themselves because they want to remain in the position that you guys are in. And I am always for students who are trying to make better. So some of these organizations don't want to give you any time off because, and I'm speaking particularly like about the BPO industry, some of them say, if you're going to school, you can't be employed. But the students, them want to work. So sometimes the students lie and say to them that they are not going to school. I've had students who drop out of the program because they can't join class, period, because them shift change. Them upon morning today, tomorrow, them yesterday upon night, and they can't come to class. And students drop out of the program because they want to work. I can't give them the money. I can understand that. But if you can focus on the work and just listen to the class and say, boy, commit to listening to the recording. So if you can listen to the work and to the class and hear what sir talking about, right? But now let's say if I have the video on, you know, because we don't want them to catch you and you go get yourself in trouble, right? But at least you hear what sir is saying and be committed to doing the recording. None of you can complain that I don't submit the recordings and submit the recordings on time. Mark, you did miss one of them because we did a try something we do not because we did look and say, on and watch the recording and we decided to be not gonna post none. And Shanti P, I don't want to say for no. Sir, I was looking for the recording and I couldn't find it. I'm saying, you know what? I did it deliberately. And that's the honest truth. I did that one deliberately. But on a whole though, I recognize that students are not coming out for classes. The institution also recognizes it. We had a meeting recently. And out of that meeting, the decision was taken to return to face-to-face. The decision was taken to return to face-to-face. And when I told my other students, they were like, sir, I said, yes. So this is when other lecturers, and only Mr. Shan alone, some people said, Mr. Shan miserable, you know, and guess what? One thing when I can't say about Mr. Shan, when I can't say Mr. Shan miserable, because sometimes I'm miserable for true, but when I can't say me not come to class, and when I can't say me not teach. If when I say it, I learn not to. You understand? And
sir, I get miserable. I'm not that true.
Yeah, man, and I'm gonna get miserable when
we don't do the work.
We don't do the work.
Yeah, man, I mean, I have no apologies for that, man. I'm telling you things, I'm telling you hot words, but guess what? You see, after me don't tell you,
It don't change the relationship that we share. If you want to vex with me, that I feel business. If Naomi don't do the work, I'm going to come to class, I'm going to rub out Naomi. If Naomi, I'm going to say, Naomi, what Naomi? If you don't want to answer me, that is your business. Come in now, no time for hold. What I am doing is to get you guys to self-actualize, to get you guys to do the very best you can. That is my aim, you know. There's nothing in it for me. Yes, dear. Yes, sir.
Me never go, me I tell you the truth. Me never go, me go for EDSAF one and two times, but guess what me do? Mm-hmm. Me print out the past paper them, so them did not work for a little bit.
Great. So, what is going to happen? No, I was saying that's all I want of you. So, what is going to happen now? Let me tell you where I have a challenge now. Because of students' behavior in the online space. We may, I'm not saying that they're going to do it because they still have some more time. Final decision will be taken from January morning. But there is a possibility where your Saturday morning class may jolly go face to face. Now, I think about those students who come to class and who participate in class, but who also have work. They have to go work for pay those people them school fee. How are those students going to manage? And I'm saying, when I come to class and say, Lord, only talk to me now, only talk to me now, only talk. It's not that because me want, you know, sometimes I'm going to be frank, I'm going to be frank with you. Sometimes on a Saturday morning, I would love to just lay down and just draw the sheet and just not just have some me time. But when I say, when the thought comes to mind, I say, but I have 31 students depending on me. I can't do that. I have 31 students. So when last week I put in class on a Friday, you know, not because I want to have a class on a Friday. Oh, hell no. No, I can't tell it straight up. I don't want to have a class on a Friday. But I look at it and say, the Saturday before, there was a mix up with a Zoom link. We never had class. And then the following Saturday, I have no class. We said, no, we could put a class in. Kerry and four other students, I can't remember who else was there. Kerry and four others. Zenika came in the Saturday morning. Zenika, were you there on Friday night too? But anyway.
Yes, sir. I was there, sir. So we had the lapata the next day.
Right. You were there to Naomi, right? So it's only a few students came in. So I'm saying, when the teacher is making this sort of, and I understand, Chantal said, why sir, them coming to work? I understand that. Don't tip someone to understand. All I'm saying to you students, just like how you expect much from the teacher also expects much from you. And the final thing I'm going to say to you before we really hit the ball going is that I'm not finished with the syllabus. Some of you are moving at snail pace on EDUCASOFT. Some of you are moving on very finished. Others are moving well. I will give you an update when I log on. The computer is very dead. So I just give a 2 minutes charge while I talk to you. I want you to completely educate yourself. Christmas is not to eat the pork and the ham and the sorry land, the this and the that alone. You have to get some work in because I don't even talk to my family about this yet, you know. I am making a decision without even including my family in this decision. But I have to have one or two classes with you. I have to, because come January 9th, God's willing, exams start. Me no want my papers on fire students pass. That not gonna look good for me. So I'm saying to you students, you have a responsibility. And I mean, every Saturday morning, I talk to you about the same thing. You have a responsibility, complete your EDUCASOFT. I know organizations know putting in some long hours. I understand that also, But you also have a responsibility. My best grades as a student came when I became an evening or a part-time student. My best grades came when I was a part-time student. When I was a full-time student and have all the time in the world, the grades that I got when I was working full-time, finished working at 5 o'clock p.m. and have class will start at 4 o'clock. I hope you get the gist of it, you know. I finish teach 5 p.m. but my class at university starts 4 o'clock. These were face-to-face classes. By the time if I drive out and if I get to school, may I catch there sometimes 1 hour later because of the traffic. Class were from 4 o'clock to 7 o'clock. Sometimes I'm going to go to class, more than half of the class gone. I'm sitting in the class.
Sir, The people them have to left work, sir. Them, and then I have to go back face to face. It's a little thing, sir. When I ask you.
I'm Chantal. And that's why you have my voice here now, because that's the conversation I'm going to be taking.
Because when I saw the email, may I say?
Oh, so you saw the email?
Yeah, I saw the email that we're going to have face-to-face exam.
So may I say,
but how am I going to do this?
But Chantal, let me tell you something. It's not people like you who come to class and talk, you know, and it's not people like you who come and say to me, sir, you send me a private message and say, sir, I have to go leave at 11 o'clock mm-hmm. coming out of work. So may I say, Chantal?
Yes, sir.
You are responsible with it. With the week when I never...
What I've tried mm-hmm. to do, I tried to call. When I call, I've been saying, dear sir. That mm-hmm. frustrate me because I have to ask for time off from work just to do my exam. So if I'm leaving, if I have to leave from work and come down that side, it's going to be very sticky for me to come down that side to do my exam. When it would have been a half an hour for me to reach home, plug in my computer, sit down on it, and do the exam and get to work ready.
Chantal, sweetheart, students like you, that when I go to these meetings, you know the last meeting I went to, I said to them that I didn't even vote. Because I was split between ideas. I'm going to tell you. You know what I'm split between? Me agree with them to put by the class in face-to-face and the exam face-to-face because some students are abusing it. Me not hide and talk. Hate me for speaking the truth. But I also, in the other mind, are very concerned about those students who are capitalizing very nicely on the online class and exams. They come to class, they're participating. Chantal, I could have walked past you enough times. And don't know, says you. But that if you open your mouth and say something, I'm going to say, Chantal, and you're going to say, who is this? And you're going to say, oh, this is Sean, right? Because we know each other by voice recognition. But there are others who sit down, and they may sit down, and you call upon them, and them not even unmute the mic and say, sir, I understand or I don't understand. And when they mark exam paper, I mark my meeting, I say, teacher in class. I say, Roops, everybody understand? Yes, sir. Any questions? No, sir. Everybody, I can mark meeting, I say, and people get under 5%. And people get under 5%. And every day, me come class and I ask, I don't understand. That's all right. So, because of that, me want the face to face too. But, Matthew, one of the things I'm going to say, me not leave my yard for computer Saturday morning class at 8 o'clock. Negative. So somebody else will have to do that. I only facilitate these Saturday classes because they're online. And I believe I am one of the, I'm not saying the best, but I'm one of the lecturers that are using the online and giving you a very good online experience.
Sir. You listen to me, you know. Sir, if I know you are going to teach me online, like face-to-face maths, then who else are going to teach me? Well, sir.
We have some good lecturers there who will do this stuff, man. No, don't get me wrong. We have some very good lecturers there who know them stuff, who can do this stuff well. But I'm just saying to you, if the students are not whole, the point I'm making, Naomi, is if the students on a whole were coming out to classes, were doing what it is that we were expecting of them in an online environment, yes, we wouldn't be having this sort of conversation. Is your classmates you're supposed to be talking to when Sarah, you know, me in a class already, you know, when was it? One class last year, I was teaching the bachelor students last year. In one class, I asked a question. Nobody now answer. And my wife, who was in the living room for online work, came into the room where I was and said, I heard you ask a question. Nobody has answered you. I said to this minute, and I decided that I wasn't going to say anything. And one student sent me a private message and said, sir, I don't understand these students. Sir, can I unmute and answer? I said, I don't want to hear from you. You have always been answering. Give me your answer and I'll mark your work. And I waited, students, in excess of half of an hour and nobody responded. And I unmuted my microphone and said, students, have yourselves a wonderful rest of the evening. Good night.
So, sir, so wish there in the evening, your teach.
No, remember next week Saturday is the last class, you know. What I'm going to say, though, is that I just need to work out something and just give some times.
Yes, sir. We're consulting. We now go function with a different teacher. No, when certain people different.
No, worry about it, man. You'll be fine. The point I'm making, though, is students, what's the moral of the story? The moral of the story is that we still will have online classes, you know, because one of the things that I keep saying to them is that we cannot make so many strides. The amount of equipment, the writing tablet that is to write with, very nicely on screen, use more lip of color. Enough money me pay for that. How my money me use and pay for it? I have my document camera. I have, if I want to use a camera with my cell phone, and not use my cell phone camera, I have all of those equipment. So me can't invest so much in online and then we now go use online ever again. And the institution is not throwing out online fully. You understand what I'm just saying? Students, you're better than that, man. You know, you come to class, just come to class and just participate. If you don't understand, nobody can laugh after you. Know, if you keep me ask a question and Naomi says something wrong and Chantal laugh after me, go Chantal. And me alone supposed to laugh, right? When I just do what I'm supposed to do, no man. I want to do what I'm supposed to do. I'm not good to go. But anyhow, with that said, there's no love lost. Let me hear from you. I sent you. Oh Lord, did I? Sir? Go ahead, Kerry Berry. That's on I carry.
Yes, sir. When is the midterm exam?
And that's a very good question. Excellent question. And I'm going to answer that in without a shadow of a doubt. It has to be next week because next week is a final class. So it has to be next week. What time next week? I may do it for the last hour of class next week. Right? But it has to be next week. And you know the history. I have been putting off because I wanted people to, you know, complete their edical software. But it has to be next week because next week is the final day of it. So next week. Thanks, Kerry.
I haven't got to do some of the things because they changed the shift that I was on. Like they gave me a 5 to 2. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty rough for me. Like they are not trying to facilitate school.
Hold on, Zenika. You are one of those students who I was referencing you and Chantal. I was referencing at work. So anything you say a while ago in terms of them not facilitating school was a lie?
No, sir.
Okay, and that's the point I'm making.
Sir, not one bit.
All right. Yeah, them not.
Them just have make people suffer all the time. And it's unfair.
It's unfair. All they're interested in, you know, is you making money for them. That's all. And guess what? And you making money for them, sometimes it don't even benefit you because the pay you is the plan of the other where they are made for them, right? So the point I'm making, what is important, that's the very point I was making. So you know what? Thank you, Zanika, and thank you, Chantal, for supporting my point. I don't want you guys to come and do something. You know what Naomi said to me at the start of the class, the start of these online classes, Naomi said to me that when she told her friends that she didn't go to school, them said to her, I said, all women don't go to school. And I said to her, you have to prove them wrong. Prove them wrong, right? Make them come at your feet and look at you and say, my goodness, Naomi, do it, we can do it too. Naomi, do it, we can do it too. So I'm saying to you students, come on. I may be miserable when I want my work, don't know. But guess what? It is for your own benefit. It is for your own benefit. I want the best of my students. I want the best for you. If you don't want the best for yourself, this is not the class for you. Can I tell you straight up? This is not the class for you. All right, let's go. So I'm going to check EDUCASOFT in a few to give you some updates. Now, let me give you a little strategy. For Edico, what I want you to do is I don't want that. Sorry. Forgive me. I'm trying to understand. YouTube always have these advertisements that come up. edu. I know. Did I not stop you? Microsoft. Good. So we have to commit ourselves and let me just ecc.edu. Let me just explain something to you. Microsoft gives you so, and for the midterms coming up, try not to get less than 15 also out of the 20%. So write this and then it's gone with 20%. I mean, 20, 30%. Right, and if you can get more out of the 40, that's fine. 30% out of 40 is 75%. All right, so if you get 75% on Edifice off and 75% on the mid-semester, you will have 30 out of 40 already. All you need is 20 more marks to pass the exam. You go into the exam and you answer your question, then you must get the 20 marks. And you must pass the course and move on. All right, so let me just scan through Edicon now and let you see what is happening. Zen, I understand, but I'm going to ask you if you can just maybe, like, and you may be going to work for later on, but. If you can, just one night, you just get up and just commit yourself to say, boy, I have to do something now, move until you get it done up. It will work. Okay, so clearly these students are not part of my class. Yeah, so the class not moving at all for the most part. Marlo, Shaquille, Dana have not started a thing. All right, Steffi, we'll see, you look like you want. You want with a big piece or something. You have 7, 8 more to complete, not bad. Ashanti is doing pretty well. Ashanti has 3 to complete. Very nice. Janil, I see something. I'm proud of you. Need a little bit more though, but I see what is happening. And Jen, you have...
Yes,
3, 6, 7. And Jenny, you know, you have 8 to do. I'm going to open one more for you. I don't like that, Grace. I mean, well, you're not finished with it. Clearly, it was already open. So you have 8 that you need to start, plus one of them, you look like you only did one question for consumer arithmetic. Steffi have the same 3 and 3, 6, 7, 8. So Steffi and JB have the same number. Ashantia has 3, very good Ashantia. Garrett clearly is not in my class because Garrett has not started. And of course, Kerry Berry has completed. All right, Kerry, let me save that one. All right, it's still open. Kerry Berry has completed. Okay, Naomi, I see movements.
Sir.
Yes, please.
Ah, this is Chanel. What are you talking about? Because I just got a chance to.
Talking about Editor Soft. All right, Naomi, I see you working 3 and 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You have 10 out. Naomi. Janelle, you have 3 and 3, 6 and 3, 9, 1, 10. Not bad. But I want you to get more. 10, 11, 12, Xavier, you have 12. Zen, you have that number to complete. You know what number that one is. Engora.
Sir, I hope it just text me.
Engora. Sister Mullins. If you don't do any more work on this thing today, your soup not going to be as nice as it's supposed to taste.
Yes, sir.
All right. Aaliyah, I see you on using your, ouch, your iPhone. I think I saw you on as Aaliyah iPhone. I don't know if that's you. Nicholson, that's you? Aaliyah iPhone is you, Nicholson?
No, sir. I'm new to the class.
Say it again. You're
new to the class, sir.
You're new to the class?
Yes, sir.
This is the end of the semester, you know. So,
I came the last two class, but they weren't being kept, so that's why.
Okay, so you're not to talk. Also, I thought you were Nicholson, Aaliyah Nicholson, because there's another Aaliyah there. All right. Chantal, you have quite a few to go through. Is Faith here? Faith Reed? All right. Faith has quite a number. Raheem is here. Raheem. Can you unmute for me, please?
Yes, sir.
What are you eating for dinner today?
Listen, sir.
What will you be eating for dinner today?
Don't know yet, sir.
It now tastes so nice. Because you have too many pieces out for your teacher. So can you do some work on it for me today, please, sir?
Yes, sir.
All right, good. Thanks.
Yes.
All right. Thank you, Papa. All right, Deshaun, not bad. You have 3 and 3, 6 and 1, 7. Hey, Deshaun, is it coming next week? You're supposed to do everything. Are you here in class now, Deshaun?
Yes, sir.
Hello. You should come next week, Saturday. Make sure they done everything. You can do it.
Yes, sir.
I like the grades, so just keep up the good work. Very nice. Jadine Thomas clearly is not a student in my class because she has not started anything. Janelle Thompson. Hi, Janelle. Are you here, Janelle? No, maybe you're not even doing the course again because no, it's in a movement. All right, Thais, are you here? Or you need to be moving much faster? Monique White. All right, I see movements, but not fast enough. You have 3 and 3, 6 and 3, 9 and 2, 11. Call it 12. Mm-mm, call it 13 because then the 2 days I forgot to do over. 13. Jamar.
I'm going to work on them, sir.
All right, cool. Thank you. Jamar, are you here, Jamar? Oh, so Jamar can't do this to me. Oh, Jamar, you, when you come to class, you participate. So we don't expect you to have so much out. Julian W., are you here? You have 3 and 3, 6 and 3, 9 and 3, 12 out. Really? Are you here? All right. I have quite a bit of Dexton. I know you are here, Dexton. Talk to me. Let me know what is happening to you.
Morning, sir.
Let me know what is happening. Morning, hon. What is happening to you?
Nothing much is really happening. You know, it's just that I'm at school right now. Wait, give me a minute. There's going to be a noise in my bathroom.
Okay. All right. You need to be moving with Edeko. You have quite a bit old. You hear?
Yes, sir. Noted.
Okay, cool. Monique W., right. Right is right here? Okay, right is not here. All right, so that's just what is happening, students. This is 20%. Don't play with it.
I haven't heard my name.
Miss Bonsbecker. Miss Bonsbecker. You're right. I don't know why I never go up there, so Miss Bonsbecker. Mm-hmm.
I haven't heard my name either.
Who is that?
Chanel Allison.
Yeah. 6 and 3, 9 and 3, 12. And Bonsfeather, you have 50. Bonsfeather, you have 50. Bonsfeather, you're too pretty to have them. Will you work your out for me, you know? Miss Bonsfeather? Allison. All right, Allison, you have. What about the same 15, you know? No, you have 16 old Ali.
Sir, I'm going to do them today.
Please and thanks. please and thanks. But Chanel is also doing this. Who is this one? Who's talking to me? Is it Chantel or Chanel?
I'm Chanel.
Oh, Rockstone. So they told me in our class now?
Long time, sir.
All right. Let me see mechanic, I guess, no. All right, no.
Sir, tell me how much we have outstanding, sir, Chantel. All right.
So, is you have next semester, Chantel? Or Chanel? No, it's Chanel I have next semester.
It's Chanel,
no,
it's Chanel. Oh, sir. Me right. Already have.
Yes, sir.
Come on. It's Chanel I have. It's Chanel I have next semester. All right. Well, Chanel, you have one more completed than Chantel. So, you have, Chanel has 3 and 3s. 3 and 3, 6 and 3, 9 and 3, 12, 12 and 3, 15. So Chanel, you have 15. Chantel, you have 16.
But so sir, Chanel, I go and I think Chanel would have this far. Because yeah. Today she pressure me. Biggie, you're not finishing the people and things.
Sir, I'm more busy with work than her.
All right, students.
Sir, it's lies. She don't want my media work now.
Students, this is sibling rivalry. Me not gonna get involved. Students, that is sibling rivalry here. We not gonna be a part of that because what can separate them is a lot. So we not gonna get involved. Yes, please.
Me no other part they go. I have a sister too. Yeah. So when the mag go on themselves, I've been there.
Yeah. So guess what? The two Allisons them. I want to shut up in a moment. I don't want to hear nothing in my class because guess what? I turn up at the bench. I don't know nothing we do know. All right. I don't know what I need to do though. All right. Okay, guys. So now that I've given you the updates on the, and incidentally, it's very good when, even though one may be struggling, you're encouraging the other. There's a sermon in that, in what was just said a while ago. But anyhow, congrats. You all know what it is that you need to do. How many of you were able to look through the topics that were done on Friday, Saturday last week on the, what do you call it now? The significant figure, standard form, decimal places, and the complex fractions. Are there any queries per se on those areas? Remember, you know. If you don't see it, talk to me. Don't not see it, I'm going to see it. Now I'll help you.
Sir, I didn't see it, sir.
You didn't see it. I know. When I say if you see it, you know, I mean, are you understanding what does that mean? So, were you able to look through the recordings?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, I look through it, but when I understand it so fully.
You don't understand it so fully. All right. Okay. Let me see. Let me see if I can do something right here. All right, so I am now the host. What I want to do with you is to see if all right, anybody see that I'm sharing?
Yes, sir, we've seen it.
Yes, sir.
It's a blank screen, though, not
none of the blank screen. Yeah. I'm trying to use a whiteboard on this thing here. Let me see. Mm-hmm. 8421.
Recording in progress.
I'm just logging another device. I'm trying to. Oh, come on, this thing. This thing not. One more, guys. I'm trying to generate another question, but it's not. I'm writing, but it's not showing. You're not seeing anything on the screen.
No, sir.
Mm-hmm. Sir, nothing on the screen. A whiteboard screen.
A white screen. Mm-hmm. Right. Open and collaborate. Human and Foundation Concept in Mathematics 1. Yeah, so that's what I'm trying to view. Hold on.
I'm trying to find another device. I'm writing the device here, so give me a minute. All right, let me give you a question in the meantime. Start working for me. And by then, I should be able to finish setting up my device. Write for me, please. For those who don't understand, don't worry about it. Just still write it. I'm setting up the device to come to you. 4 and 3/8 minus 2 and 1/5 minus 2 and 1/5 all over 3.5. Start working on that one for me, please.
Sir, where is it? 4 and 3/8.
Yes. Somebody remember some things. I just gave it to my head a while ago.
All right.
All right, so that writing tab is not working on this device. Anybody finish your question? Eh?
No, sir.
All right, go on work, go on work, go on work. I'm here. Trying something else. Obviously. Finish? Anybody?
Sir.
All right. Somebody can give me the question again, please. Four and three over eight. Oh, that's the answer?
No, sir. And two minus two and one fifth.
Mm-hmm.
Overall, 3.5.
What you guys got for the answer?
Sir, isn't it 2 and 1/5, sir?
For the answer?
No, sir, for the second part of it.
Me no member. You get the question what I'm in head? Yes, she said 4 3/8 minus 2 1/5 over 3.5.
Okay, sir.
Mm-hmm. Let me know what your final answer is. All right, I'm going on. I'm just responding to some direct messages. All right, very good, Kerry. That's what I got for Kerry. The rest of you, let me know what it is that you're getting. The answer that Kerry got is what I got. All right. All right. Now, I think it's important for me to say something while you work. Listen to me, please. There is a change of climate. It's winter. Though it's not snowing in Jamaica, the conditions are generally cooler than it normally would have been. As a result of that, a lot of respiratory challenges
have come to the fore. I myself sometimes feel a little, you know, down. Family members, you know, in my household are also having this, the sniffles. Please monitor it.
Sir, as like no, my throat are from
one. Yeah, man. Monitor it because I mean, COVID is, it's still with us. And we don't want you to think that it is the common flu and you normally make the flu run the course and then it's COVID and then you know what will happen. So please monitor it. Chantal, you need, I want you to talk to me afterwards. Yeah, Chantal, please. I need to share something with you. Based on what you shared in class today.
Okay.
So please, there are members in the group here that are not well. And I want you to be just be mindful of it. If you are asthmatic, please to cover yourself, meaning cover your chest, wear your undershirt.
Sir, if you wear a triple shirt,
You're so an asthmatic, Chantal.
I am.
It's the same thing. If you wear a triple shirt, man, it is.
I think I had an episode last week, Sunday. I had to be out from work for 2 days because of the whole climate change. Yeah, I don't have sinus issues going on, but not really paying it much mind. Just use taking my regular over-the-counter stuff. My vitamin C and use my asthma pump, but then I just wake up the morning and just feel my chest a hurt me, my sinus a bother me, my head a hurt me, my eye they must scratch me, they must run water. So yeah, you know, just have to pay attention to it. Because the first thing I'm gonna rule out, say a COVID I have, and it more coming like flu symptoms that are, you know, when you just like catch the flu, that's how it started off with the itchy throat, the sore throat, the sneezing, the runny eyes, and the itchy eyes, and all of that. That's how COVID started off first. So, I have to be mindful of it. And that make it worse, the breeze blowing, so you know, all of that dust coming.
And the dust.
If you have to change in the bed linen every week or every 2 weeks, you have to try that.
And the curtains too, because it's surprising to know how much dust the curtain. Curtains.
And changing the curtains also. Yeah, I feel that too. And why I'm washing off the fan too.
Oh, tell me about
the fan.
I have to be very careful. All right. My system is behaving as if it wants us to be at war. All right. I'm going to see if I can. I'm going to see if I can write something here for you now. All right. This looks like it is ready to behave. Let me, oh, I'm not sharing, so go to the bottom, go ahead. Share from this new device, control A. All right, so let me hear. Did anybody else get 87 over 140?
So I got the 87, just not the 140.
What you got?
I got 87 over 40.
Over 40?
Yes, sir.
Okay, no problem. Anybody else?
Sir, work it out. Make me sick. Okay.
Having some challenges.
Wait, sir.
Go ahead.
So actually, because I don't think I'm finished because I was working
out. Right, yes, because sir, the numerator LCM is 40. So I was about to say to you that I don't think you're finished because the denominator, you don't incorporate the denominator in it yet. But anyhow, I hear Naomi asks, it appears that persons are in trouble. And I would expect, especially the ones who weren't here last week, to maybe have a challenge. But let's go. So the question was,
understand, 3.5, all over 3.5,
other part. Yeah, it's not that. I'm just saying that nothing is working for me this morning. The devices. Now, let me try this again. Four and 3/8 minus 2 1/5. Are you seeing it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We're seeing it.
Good. So, what it is that I have sent off to you, and
I'm going to have my glasses.
In the WhatsApp group, and the encouragement is to work out your numerator. The thing is acting up, guys. Hold on.
Sure. That all over. I understand. So for the LCM.
All right, so the numerator is going to be, I'm converting my numerator from a mixed number to an improper fraction. We're converting the numerator from a mixed number to an improper fraction. Look at what I'm doing. I'm saying 4 times 8, and then I'm going to be adding the numerator. So 4 times 8 is 4, it's 32. And 32 plus 3 is equal to what?
35.
So it's going to be 35 over 8. Similarly, 5, this 5 down here, 5 times 2 is 10, and 10 plus 1 is 11. So this is going to be 11 over 5. And the LCM here is going to be?
40.
And 8 into 40 goes 5 times, and 5 times 35 is how much?
175.
Very good. 175. And 5 into 40 goes 8 times, and 8 times 11 sounds like 88. And when I subtract 88 from 175, I'm going to get 87.
So that's why I get 87 over 40. Now that's my numerator. Now I need to work out the denominator. Uh-oh. Sir, work out the denominator? Yeah, man. So 3.5 is the same thing as 3 times 2 is 6, and 6 and 1. 6 plus 1 is 7. So I'm going to have 7/6. All right? So
sir,
that's my
sir, I'm to your screen this week.
Sir, 7/2.
Screen.
7/2. Nothing is wrong. Nothing is wrong with the screen now. Everybody has seen the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Thanks, Kerry Berry. 7/2. All right. So 3 times 2 is 6 and 6 plus 1 is 7. So 7/2. Now, when we're combining, what I want you to do is to see that I'm saying 87 divided by 40. And that in turn is being divided by 7/2. Now, in working that out, what we're going to have is 87/40. I've shown you already how it is that and why it is that we are inverting and multiply. I showed you that before. I'm trying to get the denominator. You know, let me show you again for those of you who would have missed it. So I am multiplying by the inverse in the denominator. And the inverse of the denominator, 7/2, is 2/7. And since I'm multiplying the denominator by 2/7, I have to multiply the numerator also by 2/7. Why, sir, did we multiply the denominator by 2/7? 7 times 2 is 14. And 2 times 7 is 14. And that is equals to 1. So I'm trying to get my denominator to be 1, because when I divide anything by 1, it is the same thing. Talk through. Hello, somebody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what I now have is to work out is going to be 87/40 multiplied by 2/7. I'm no longer interested in the denominator, and that's why we invert and multiply, for no other reason. I know a lot of teachers just say invert and multiply without telling you why, but this is a reason. We invert and multiply because we want to get the denominator equals to 1. All right, so now, because the denominator is equal to 1, we can ignore the denominator and then work with the numerator. And the numerator is going to be 87/40 times 2/7. And this is what is going to happen. I can say 2 into itself 1 time and 2 into 40 goes 20 times. And 87 times 1 is 87 and 7 times 20 is going to be 140. And that's how we get our final answer. Now, tell me. 87. Any questions?
No, sir. I understand.
Sure.
Okay, good. I'm happy. All right. So, continuing this question, I want you to write this answer now exactly. I want you to write it in to one significant figure, and I also want you to write it to 6 decimal places. And then now I want you to write it in standard. Then I want you to write it in standard form. So start for me, please. All right? We should be finished by now. We should be finished by now. What is your answer? 87 over 140 written exactly. Hello, somebody.
Sure, repeat that, sir.
I'm asking, what is your answer written exactly?
0.62142871.
Nobody agrees with that? That is correct. That's a one mark. You'll get about 4 marks for this up here. A mark for doing the inversion, and a mark for the final answer. To one significant figure. What is the answer to one significant figure? What is your answer to one significant figure? Talk to me. Okay, Zenzen, I see your response to the standard form question, but I'm going to ask you to look back at that standard form answer.
Sir, this is my biggest downfall, especially when it comes here.
What, the fraction stuff?
Not the fact, working on the fraction is fine, you know, but then when you have to come here and find to one significant figure, then what is 6 decimal place, and then the standard form. That is where I fall short.
All right. So you understand the first part, the exact value part, right?
Right.
Okay. So let's go then. For the one significant figure. Yeah.
Sir, I don't understand the exact part.
You're going to put in 87 over 114 on the calculator.
And that's it, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Do you tell me know where you get it?
Okay, sir. Hold on.
Okay, I don't need to step over. We didn't know you, Gigi. Tell me. Hello?
Sir, hold on. I do it, sir. Just, I don't have my computer right now, so I'm using the computer on my phone. Okay. I got it, sir.
Good job. All right, now. So,
thank you so much.
All right, Julian, you will place in the group. Hold on. You place in a group 0.6.
Can somebody tell me what that point six answer would be the answer to? What question?
Number two, sir.
One signature. Oh, yeah, I get an echo.
Okay, sir. Phone are freeze.
The point six is saying that it is one to one decimal place. The point six is saying that it's to one decimal place. Point six is saying to one decimal place.
Sir, you're talking for Julian's answer, sir.
I'm talking about Williams. Yeah, Williams' answer.
So I think that her answer is for the significant figure, sir.
I know. So that's what I'm saying. So to one significant figure. All right. Okay. All right. I'll leave that one alone. Let me go to the six decimal places. Let me go to, where am I? Let me go to the six decimal places. What's the answer to six decimal places?
Sir, is it 0.621?
0.62,
sir. What? 4. Okay.
0.621429.
Everybody
understand
the last nine?
Oh, yes, sir.
I'm
just assuming.
Think
of it.
Yes, sir.
Five.
Oh, sir.
Yes, Naomi.
Sir, may I ask you a question? So, what? Guess what? No. Normally, when me do decimal, would I take the decimal from the back and come up? I do it from the front and come back.
Mm-mm. We don't need to say it.
Oh, may I wonder?
Mm-mm. We don't need to say it.
Okay, sir.
Mm-hmm. So remember now, when you're writing the decimal places,
sir,
you're going to look at the number that is, in the, as for six decimal places, you have one, two, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The sixth one is 8. You must look at the seventh one. If the seventh one is greater than or equal to 5, you're going to add 1 to the number. You're going to add 1 to the number, right? So it's, that 8 is going to turn to 9. And if anybody give 0.621422228, would have gotten it wrong. It has to be 29. Now, Naomi, this is what we're talking about now. In standard form, come Chantal, I hear you say don't like this. In standard form, we're looking for the first whole number. So it's going to be 6.214. You can write the other digits times 10 to what number, positive or negative 1?
Negative 1.
Negative 1. Remember what Sarah says? When you go to the, for the regular number line, the regular number line, when you go to the right-hand side, it's positive. When you go to the left on the number line, the left-hand side, it's normally negative. But in standard form,
in standard form, you're going to reverse it. You're reversing it. What do you mean by reverse, sir? That means in standard form, when you go to the right, it's going to be negative. Now watch me. See, I'm going to the right. See, I'm going to the right. Bam, I need a first whole number. That's going to the right. That's a right-hand side direction. So the mere fact that I'm going to the right-hand side is going to be reversed. It's going to be negative. So that's why I have a negative one. And why I want? Because I move only one place, one position, right? So that's why I'm going to have negative one. Very important. Very, very important. All right. Any questions? Any questions?
No, sir. I understand. No.
All right. I'm going to put, by the way, in it. Oh, did we work past papers last? You know, we did past papers last time. We did all the questions from the past papers that we got. Anybody got any more past papers? Any new past papers? We dropped some in the group last week. Thanks again to Ashantia, and I think it was Ashantia who sent those. And if there is anybody else, thank you. Really appreciate it. Let me just make up another one. Go ahead, please.
Before you make up another one, you can go back up to the next one, please.
Go back up to which one? The top part?
Yes, sir. About the significant figure, sir. How do you get 0.6 for the significant figure?
All right. So significant. Okay. So if I give you, if for example, I give you 0.1256, my first significant figure is going to be 1. This is insignificant because it's a 0. So my first significant figure is 1. Then my Then my second significant figure is this one. My third significant figure. And this is my fourth significant figure. All right? So that's one example. Two examples. If I say to you 0.0000465, which is the first significant figure?
4.
Ah, very good. So if they get that question like that, to one significant figure, to one big fig, as we call it, it's going to be 0.1245 and that 4. It's not just going to be 4, you know. So to one significant figure, you have to go right out to 0.000004. But a matter of fact, to one, and that will be plus 1. So you're getting 0.000005. Because remember, we have to look at the other number that comes after. And if that number is 5, we're going to add 1 to it.
Yes, sir.
This will be 0.0024. And then I'm going to add 1 to it. So I'm going to get 5. So this is going to be my answer. All right?
So okay,
what I'm saying, no problem, but what I'm saying to you is, if you have a 0 in front of the decimal place, it is insignificant. And because that 0, okay, watch me. To one significant figure, what is the answer?
Sir, wouldn't the answer be itself? 1.0001.
No. It would be 1. Because now this number is significant. Because it's not 0.
Because it holds a value.
Right. So if I ask you to write this now to to four significant, all right, to two significant figures. So to one sig figure, the answer is equals to 1. To two significant figures, what's the answer? Hit or no?
Sir, would it be 1.0002?
Mm-hmm. 1.0.
Okay.
Because you know what happened? It's because this one here is significant. It now makes this zero significant. You remember that this zero up, no, up this example, let me spotlight, see where you follow where I'm going. In this example up here, we had this zero right here. And this zero is insignificant. So it makes all the other zeros that come after them, after this one, also insignificant. But let us look at example three, 1.000256. The mere fact that you have a one right here, it now makes this zero, and the other zero significant. It makes them significant. Let me talk truth. Supposing to say, we can trouble in a class today. Chanel. Chanel have her good work, you know, although she won't change it, but she have her good work. And Chanel, when she finish her stuff, Chanel will go in at the bank for work. But them offer Chanel 3 times as much money as Chanel get now. And Chanel say, Chantel, my gun left, you know, and money we say. All right. And me supposed to get change one check to $100,000. And she decides, said, sure, one of the zeros is not significant. How much money never get?
So repeat the question.
I'm supposed to change a check for $100,000. But Chanel decides that one of the zeros is not significant. And she dropped off one of the zeros because she said, sure, it's not significant. How much money should I give me? Remember, you know, what I'm saying is that my check is supposed to be $100,000. But she's saying that the money, that one of the zeros, it's not significant. How much money are we going to end up getting?
$10,000.
Is there a difference between $100,000 and $10,000?
Yes, sir.
All right, let me ask. No, Zenith, I don't feel so well. Women can't trouble. Dexton, unmute for me, please.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Still working at the Christmas, yeah, eh? Your boss, you will be working and can't even come in session class. And when you took up your overtime and everything, you're supposed to get 100,000 and say, you know what? You know, me can put on a little money for pay excess to come next semester. And when you look on your check, you say only $10,000. How you feel?
Sir, more than feel away.
That's how you feel. All right, you're the good one. Let me ask somebody else. You're the good one. All right, mommy. Chantel.
Sir, nobody call for me, sir. I work with this, sir. I have a whole heap of customers, sir. Me can't do no work today, sir.
You know what I was going to say, Chantel? You are the rebel, you know. Same, him can't run him drug in the first place, don't. You can't tell?
No, sir.
Negative. From him see your face, him knows there's something wrong. All right, very good. So it is significant. It is significant. Significant. So you see, and why that number is significant is because of this one right here. That one is significant, so it makes every other number significant. So if when you decide, say, this number is significant, but these other zeros behind you are not significant, you're going to get Chantel's wrath. Don't play with me. We don't play them games here. $100,000, I'm going to forget. I mean, you're right. Some of that, you know, the same category. There's a big difference between $100,000
and $10,000. So when the zero comes after a significant figure, the zeros are significant. All right? When the zero comes before the first significant figure, like in this example too, this value here is insignificant. So therefore, the other zeros are insignificant until you reach the four. All right? Very, 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 very important. Very important. Please, very, very important. All right. Are there any other questions?
Okay. Sir, go back 1 minute, please.
Sure, not a problem. Where? Here or up top?
Okay, sir. Thanks.
Okay. All right, let me give you one for the road. All right, let me just evaluate this. All right, start working from a piece. I'm going to put a few more things on it for you to do. I don't have enough space to write. Let me see if I go down here. So, yeah, I don't have enough space to write right here. All right, start off from here. I'll give you 3 minutes. Start, please. Let me just give you a hint. The denominator for this one is going to be very big. Don't worry about it. They may not give you a big denominator one in the exam. I only did this because I just write it out of my head. Don't worry about it. Just use the principles and just work on it for me, please. That's all I want you to do. All right? Thanks.
All right. Let's go. Anybody finish?
No, sir, not quite.
All right, come, we have to go. We have to go. What time is it now? 10:41. All right, let's go. Work with me. Work with me. Sir, say it again.
I was saying I was finished.
Oh, what are you going to say, answer?
Mm-hmm. 602/4365.
Very good, very good, Carberry. You're correct.
Yes, sir. But if you put that as a decimal, you get a longer answer.
Yeah, man, no problem. Mm. And I would expect that. All right. As a decimal, what do you get for that?
Sir, 0.13791523
Very good. Yeah, man. Very nice. Love it. All right,
sir,
let's go.
My upside down. Because the 4,000 is the numerator and the 630 is the denominator. So me put it to.
Then I blame it on the Snickers. Here is Enzin. All right. Let me. All right. I'm happy that at least you've got the values. You need to know work on the order. All right. The numerator, converting the numerator, 1 times 5 is 5. 5 plus 2 is 7. So this is going to become 7/5. Everybody, so we'll convert that from a mixed number to an improper fraction. We did this long time. Okay, good. Good. -4/9. LCM, 5 times 9 is 45, don't.
Yes, sir.
And what is 9 times 7?
62. Mm-hmm. 63, sir.
Mm-hmm.
66, sir.
No. And a 63.
Yes, sir. 63 take away 6 equal 43 over 45. Me get the numerator part. Mm-hmm.
All right. And then now the denominator is going to be 5 over 2 plus 4, 7, 28, 31 over 7. Oh.
Yes, sir.
What's the LCM?
14.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then 2 into 14 goes 7 times and 7 times 35.
Yes, sir. Plus.
This is the problem, you know. 7 into 14 goes 2 times, 62, don't.
Yes, sir.
Equal. And it's what, 97?
97.
Yeah. 14.
Right.
So I'm going to go wrong.
So you know how 43 over 45, 45. Divided by 97 over 14, which is the same thing as 43 over 45 multiplied by 14 over
97.
And you know, so not we can cancel out, you know, anything can cancel out.
No, sir.
No, so is multiplied 43 multiplied by 14 equals 602.
Yes, sir.
And then the 45 multiplied by 97 is 4365. 705. And that's our final answer. 4365. four three six five. And that's your answer. No, exactly as a decimal. Your answer is going to be 0.137915234. And here my trouble, Kerryberry now. Because Kerryberry don't have expensive calculator. Here our calculator support 4. My calculator go up to 8. This is Liberty Kerryberry.
Oh, watch him.
All right. So, but if you don't have the 8, it's not a problem. You stop over the 2, 3, 4, you're good to go, right? So that is exactly what you have. All right, let's go. And what was the other part of the question again? It says, let's see. Standard form to 2 decimal places, standard form. It's going to be, I'm going to write 1.379 times 10 to the positive 1. Am I correct?
No.
What am I supposed to have?
Negative 1.
Negative 1, very good. To the negative 1, and that will be my final answer. And then to... two decimal places. I'm going to have 0.14.
Yes, sir.
That's 1 mark each. That's about 4 marks. So that's at least 7 marks out of 7. Any questions?
Okay. No, sir.
All right. I want to move on. Waiting on the rest of it to write off. All right. How are we feeling? I don't mean to disturb it, you know.
Sir, I understand.
All right, cool.
Sir, I would just need to be just, you know, do the assignment, then, you know, I work on that so we get to understand better. You know, understand the brains. So.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. All right.
Sir, I'm going... now I'm going to feel good today. I hear me not that. Which was that hurt me?
Osh. Just.
I go doctor later. They come over class.
Yeah. Just be safe here. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
All right. So let me move into some basic algebra. Very basic algebra. You know, I don't even think I should. All right, let me just refresh something here. Let me refresh something here. Do those two questions on me, please. Matter of fact, let me stop and ask a question. Have we done this before?
Not what I remember, sir.
Yes, sir. It never ended, sir.
I've done this long time, Chantal.
Yeah. So I never come for ADS after.
Long time. Remember
sir, what you remember, you know. I see the second question that I'm a big, me tell you, big, me fight with it. But I'm all getting right. There. I'm getting there.
No problem. It's just something that came into my spirit a while ago, and I said, let me just look at something, and then I put it there. But yeah, we did this long time. Remember, what them two short known as? Them two here, wait, known as? And wait, mean?
So I think it's something to do with absolute value.
Oh, bless your heart. What's that?
Sir Dexton.
Okay, very good, Dexton. So that means we did it then, right, Dexton?
Sir.
All right, Dexton. So what absolute values mean, Dexton?
What I can recall is that when there is a number. Sorry.
Not hearing you.
What I can recall is that when there's a number in those two strokes, so like say you have -6 with those two strokes, I know that the absolute value of that would be +6.
Mm-hmm.
And if you had the +6 in the two strokes, the absolute value of that would be +6 itself.
Very good. So the absolute value, you can't always select it, it's always positive. All right, work on those two sort of things, quick and fast.
Excuse me, sir. Sir?
Yes, please. Sorry. Go ahead.
So when is the next semester, sir?
Next week.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Naomi, sweetheart, can you mute your mic, please?
Sorry.
You have one right now. Oh my God, I'm learning. I am learning. Eat material.
What is that? Remember, these online classes can be intrusive, so we have to keep our phones on mute. All right, anybody finish? Talk to me now.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let me... What do you have for your answer?
Sir, for which one?
First one.
Sir, I got 32.5.
Same.
32.5?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. I don't know if you're right. Let us work it.
Sir, well on. So I'll still finish number two question.
All right. Hold up. Can I go now?
Talk yes, to me. Sir.
Ah, good. So what Bumda says? Bumda says I have to work with my exponents first, don't?
Yes, sir.
So 4 fours.
16.
So we have 16 times 2 plus 5 divided by 7 plus 3. Then I'm going to work with my bracket. Okay. PEMDAS, P-E-M-D, PEMDAS, same difference. Brackets, parentheses mean the same thing. Eh? The O and the E mean the same thing. Exponent or order. And of course, you know, multiplication and division before addition and subtraction. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So the next thing I'm going to work with is this 7 plus 3. So this is 16 times 2 plus 5 divided by, what is 7 plus 3?
10.
All right, so I've worked with my brackets. I've worked with my exponents. The next step is what? Multiplication, don't?
Yes, sir.
All right, so look at what I'm doing. I'm going to be identifying my multiplication sign, and I'm going to write in a number to the left, to the right of it. And work it out. So I'm going to get 32. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So now I'm going to have 32 plus 5 divided by 10. What's my next operation? Addition. Is there an addition there? No, sorry. Division. Oops. Here's a division. So I'm looking, identify my division sign. Looking to the left and the right of it. So it's going to be 5 divided by 10, which is equal to 1/2. So what I now have is going to be 32 plus 1/2. And 32 plus 1/2 is 32.5. So very good for those of you who got it. Excellent. Any challenge at all from the rest of you? Hear me out. This is what I was building on Edicosoft from day one. None of you, especially those who were with me from day one, should have an issue with this, because this is what we were working on. And we did, what was something called again? MOPS, multiple option practice sheets. Remember when we time myself, I'm working quick and fast. Anybody remember those exercises?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Work. Anybody remember that?
Yes, sir.
All right. So you know why nobody say they don't remember offer them something. That's why we never do no work on Edicosoft.
Sir.
Yes, please.
The 32. Oh, mm-hmm. Whenever I get that part here. Wait, 32. After you have 16 times 2 equal 32. That's the answer, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then, all right, let's see where I'm going to go wrong. All right, let's see.
So remember, you know, BOMDAS, BOMDAS, or PEMDAS, PEMDAS, the B and the P are saying the same thing. What is the B and the P saying? The B and the P are saying, what are they saying? Brackets and parentheses. Bracket mean parentheses. Parentheses mean bracket. All right? It says, once I have my brackets first, work those first. Then if I have an O, which is an order, or E, which is an exponent, order and exponent mean the same thing. If I have an exponent, work that next. And then when I finish work on all, I just write them back. So you see, I wrote the 4 squares and I get 16. I write it back. I just put 16 times 2 plus 5 divided by that. Then know the next thing to work with is my brackets. But sir, what if you work with the brackets first and then the exponents afterwards? Not a problem. And then I'm going to end up with 16 times 2 plus 5 divided by 10. What is the next operation? Division. So I'm going to look for my division sign, look to the left and right of it, and then do that operation. So it's 5 divided by 10, put the 5 up top, whichever one comes first up on top. 5 divided by 10, 5 over 10. 5 over 10 is a half. So now we're going to have 32 plus a half, which is my next operation, addition. 32 plus 1 half is 32 and a half. But sir, we never have a subtraction, and so we're not going to have all of the operations to do. All right? All right, this is revision, you know. And for your stuff next week, matter of fact, I may put in a revision class. Not me, I'm going to put in a revision class this week. Those who can make it, please feel free.
So you have to tell me I wish dear, sir. You have to tell me dear.
I'm going to tell you the day, man. I have to tell you the day.
Sir, not Wednesday, no, not the 14th for me. You know, we have wait name. Oh,
stop party
ceremony. No award ceremony for workplace award ceremony.
Okay, so for me, I'm gonna ask if I who are your class party, you know, class party, your office party. If you don't want to give me another food, make it tell me, say, no, come. All right, let's go. Where was I? Oh, can somebody? I hate going back and forth. Do me a favor. Can somebody read the second part of the question for me, please? I don't want to make any mistake. Read the second part of the question for me, please. The second question.
Sir, 4.
Mm-hmm.
Negative 6 divided by 2.
By 2?
2. Uh-huh. Plus 3 minus 5.
All right. Now, inside my absolute value sign, I have quite a bit of operations to work. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to leave the absolute value sign for now and just work inside of the stuff, the absolute value sign. What I'm going to write is my BOMDAS. Every time I do the question, I'm going to write on BOMDAS so I don't make any mistakes. Yes, I have a bracket. The bracket is with my absolute value, A-B-S-O-L-U-T-E. My absolute value sign. That's my bracket, you know. Okay, work the same way. But I'm going to do that one last because there are some other little things inside of the stuff, inside of the brackets. So I have to go simplify those stuff first and then apply the brackets business afterwards. Is there any exponent? Somebody said no.
No, sir.
Is there any multiplication?
Yeah.
There is?
Yes, sir.
Where?
Sir, that would be after you find out the value.
Uh-huh. After I find out everything, then I'll have the multiplication of what?
Four times
what? Very good. Excellent. So when I ask if there is any multiplication, what I said before, you know, what I'm working out is inside my absolute value sign. So there's no multiplication inside my absolute value sign, but yes, there is one on the outside. So that's just going to be afterwards. Now, is there any division? You see, I'm going down in bumdas. Is there any division in the absolute value?
Yes, sir.
Good. So I'm going to look to the left and the right of it. So to the left of the absolute value, to the left of the division sign is -6. To the right of it is 2. So it's going to be -6 divided by 2, which is equal to what?
-3.
Very good. Look at what Sir is being next done and the rest of you. As I don't hear the rest of you talking to me, I am rewriting my question, because every time I rewrite my question, I'm reducing it so that we see what we now have. And trust me, for each of these steps, you get a mark. So now I'm going to reduce that to be -3 plus 3 minus 5. Talk truth.
Yes, sir.
All right. The rest of them next time, let them go on home. But never mind. So is there any more division?
No, sir.
All right. And there's a reason why I ask if there's any more division, because sometimes in the question you have multiple multiplication, multiple division, multiple additions, and multiple subtractions. Eh? So we have to double check. So there's no more division. So we'll move to addition. Is there any addition?
Yes, sir.
Look to the left and right. -3 plus 3. What is that?
0. 0
every time. So now I'm rewriting. Every single time I'm going to rewrite. So it now becomes 4 absolute value, 0 minus 5. Uh-oh. What is 0 minus 5?
5.
Excuse me?
-5.
Okay, thank you, please, Terry Berry. So it's 4 times negative 4 absolute value, -5. Mm-hmm. How do I move from here now? It is 4 times the absolute value of -5. What does that work out to be? What is the answer?
20.
Positive 20 or negative 20?
Positive 20.
Very good. So the answer is going to be positive 20. Excellent. Anybody put negative 20? If the question is 5 marks, you are going to get 4 or maybe 3. Because you have to now recognize that the absolute value of -5 is positive 5. And remember how we get the absolute value of those negative to be positives? Let me just give a refresher. We've done this before. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. -5, -4, -3, -2, -1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right, so this is how we go. So we're at -5. This is my 0. My starting point. So -5, it means that I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 places to get back to my original point. I'm not looking at signs. I'm looking at the positions. So it means that I need 5 places to get back to my 0. Let me look at +5. How many places do I need to go? 1, 2, 3, 4. I also need 5 places. So that explains why the absolute value of -5 is equal to +5, but also the absolute value of +5 is also equal to +5. That's the reason. That's the reason, right? So the absolute value of a number is always positive. The absolute value of a number is always positive. What I'm going to do for you, this week I'm going to be a little rough for me. What I'm going to do for you, I'm going to send you a little worksheet in preparation for the mid-semester. Remember,
in order for you to pass its course. Maximize on the mid-semester. I have already gone through, you know, everything on that mid-semester paper. I have gone through with you. Every single thing on the mid-semester paper, I have gone through with you. Every one of them. But guess what? For those of you who don't complete your EDICASOFT, we'll have a challenge. We'll have a challenge. Now, your mid-semester must be next week, Saturday, because on paper, next week, Saturday, is the final class. We still have to come meet and have more classes because we don't finish. But the other classes that I have to go meet and find out, I will have to go on and request those Zoom links. Next week is the last week that the college is going to send out Zoom links for classes. So everything else is left up to me not to go and find Zoom links to send to you guys. You must complete your EDICASOFT pieces in order for you to maximize on the mid-semester. It is possible for you to go in there and get 100% on the mid-semester. Just imagine you getting 100% on the mid-semester. That's a 20 marks out of 20, you know. And you finish your EDICASOFT and do very well on EDICASOFT, so you get 18 out of EDICASOFT. That's a 38 out of 40, you know. And you go in on the exam and mash it up at 8 plus that, you know. It is possible. It is still possible. All right? Still possible. Can I move or do you need two more? All right, so I'm going to move. Did you hear a response? I'm going to move. So I'm moving to some basic algebra. I want to see how well you can do your substitutions. So if I give you, given A equals 3, B is equal to 0, and C is equal to negative 1, I want you to evaluate A plus B times C over A plus B. And I want to work this one with you. I want to work this one with you. So A plus B, and of course that is being multiplied by incidentally. Remember commutative law and the associative law and the distributive law. Hello, somebody?
Sure, come again, please. I didn't hear that.
Commutative law, the distributive law, and the associative law. Anybody remember those?
Yes, sir.
Important for the mid-semester. I'm almost sure it's going to be there. Anybody remember additive inverses, multiplicative inverses? I spoke about a multiplicative inverse when I was doing this question. Where is the question? You see this question here in red? We have 87 over 40 divided by 7 over 2. When you're going to little school, teacher say multiply and invert, invert and multiply. They don't explain to you why you have to invert and multiply, but this is the reason. You're trying to get the denominator equals 1. Because when you divide anything by 1, you get back that same thing. So the aim is to get the denominator to be equal to 1. So you have to multiply the denominator by its inverse. So the inverse of 7 over 2 is going to be 2 over 7. All you have to do is to reciprocate it. All you have to do is to reciprocate. What is in the numerator now becomes the denominator. What is in the denominator now becomes the numerator. So when I reciprocate 7 over 2, I'm going to get 2 over 7. When I multiply a number by its inverse, the result will always be 1. When I multiply a number by its inverse, the result is always going to be 1. So therefore, 7 over 2 times 2 over 7 is equal to 1. So it doesn't matter what I do with the denominator anymore because I'm going to have one. So all I know have to work out is my numerator. And that is the reason they used to tell us to multiply and invert. Don't ask me if that didn't mean anything to me. No, it didn't. All me know is you're supposed to invert and multiply. But this is the reason. So I spoke about the multiplicative inverse. What is the additive inverse? Which number is the additive inverse? What's the additive inverse, class? What's the additive inverse of one? Oh my Lord.
Sir, repeat that.
What is the additive inverse of one?
Negative one, sir.
Negative
Thank
one.
Thank you, Terry Berry. Thank you very much, dearest. And I'll see you back in the private lessons that we've been having every day of the week. You hear?
Yes, sir.
Because clearly we are having private lessons and the others are not part of it. Come on, no class. What is a multiplicative identity? What number is a multiplicative identity? Okay, stop. What is a multiplicative identity of? What is a multiplicative identity? What do I multiply by 3 to get its identity?
3, 1.
3, 1. 1, 1. 1, 1,
yes.
1.
Remember, identity means it's a lookalike.
Okay.
Don't, when you say somebody identical, don't they lookalike?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, man, it's another same concept, man. And they lookalike, who want, you know? So the multiplicative identity of 5 is going to be 5 because 5 times 1 is 5. All right, so those are things that you need to know from Saturday morning. I'm positive. Have we gone through those things in class before? Just checking. No? Yeah? Somebody talk to me.
Yes, sir.
Absolutely. And all the recordings are there in the YouTube channel. All the recordings are there in the YouTube channel. All right, let's go. So in doing this question, all we are going to be asked to do is to, I'm reminded of the multiplicative inverses and so forth. When I look at this question and the distributive law and the commutative law, when I look at this question, eh? So when we look at this question here, all we're going to be doing is substituting. What's the value of A?
3.
And what's the value of B?
0.
What's the value of C?
-1.
What's the value of A again?
3.
And what's the value of B?
0.
If you do that, you get 1 mark. If you are able to substitute the values correctly for the question, you get a mark. So for those of you who decide, say, you're going to do it on rough work paper and not write it in your book so it is that we can't on your exam paper so we can see it, you're losing that mark. Because if I only see the answer, you're getting the mark for the answer alone. So for those of you who have your rough work paper we'll be having your rough work paper in the exam and not show this, you can't have a dark. Because I expect to see it. It is going to be expected of you that we see it. All right? And then you know, what is 3 plus 0? What is 3 plus 0 plus?
3.
All right? And that will be 3 times -1. What is? And this is over 3.
What is
3 times -1?
-3.
And what is -3 divided by 3?
-1.
All right. Was that difficult? Was that difficult?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Let me ask, sir.
Mm-hmm.
The multiple created identity, where you just talked about a while ago, is any number that you multiply by the next number and it not change? Like if we say one multiply by five and we get back this, the number not change?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Thanks.
So what I'm saying to you is the number one is known as a multiplicative identity. Because when I multiply one by any number, I get back that same number. So one is known as a multiplicative identity.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right. There's something that I'm not too comfortable with you guys with. But I did ask a question and nobody responded, so I'm gonna leave it. And we have half an hour left.
Which question did you ask?
No man, I was the complex fractions.
Which fraction, sir?
Yeah. Are you okay with it?
I didn't hear what he said. You were breaking up.
No man, I'm saying to you that when I ask about the complex fractions, I'm not too comfortable.
Come, sir. Do it over. Come, do it.
No, what I'm saying, I'm not too comfortable with students with the complex fractions. Are you okay with the complex fractions?
Me not okay with it so fully, sir. But I just take my time. But okay. Can you know, refresh us with it?
Complex.
So, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, that the one that you're right now is a complex and the
complex fraction.
Yeah, cause guess what? No, cause the numerator fraction and the denominator fraction too.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
So you have plenty of fraction or something. That's why it's complex.
Okay, sir.
Sir, I'm finished.
All right, come in. You know what I'm going to do? After these two questions, I'm going to give you an opportunity to the remaining 10 or so, 15 minutes so that we'll have in the class to start working on your EDUCASOFT. I'm going to give you the remaining time to work on your EDUCASOFT. What I promised to do for you before the weekend is out, I can't tell if it's going to be today or tomorrow. If by, I have a function tomorrow at 4, you know, yeah, man. If by, say, 8 o'clock tomorrow night, not so late. If by 5 o'clock tomorrow, you don't see the questions, just send me a WhatsApp message to say, sir, remember the questions, please. I'm going to send you some questions, some practice questions that I want you to work on for me. And we're going to see if we can have a group. I can't meet with you on Tuesday because I have a class on Tuesday. So the times that I have available to meet with you would be Monday. Naomi says she can't meet her Wednesday because she has a function. I can meet you on Monday and I can meet you on Friday. And of course, we have our class on Saturday. But of course, I have to meet you before Saturday because I want to just make sure that you're where you're supposed to be. So,
sir, Monday, what time on Monday?
It would have been another, well, I can do it another day on Monday, you know. But some people can have work. But I can also do it in the evening at 5 o'clock. Sir,
I have classes all day on Monday, so it has to be in the evening for me.
Okay, so 5 o'clock then. Everybody would be at 5 o'clock Monday? Everybody, anybody else has class? How many of you good? All right, don't answer me now. Drop it in the WhatsApp. If those of you who have a challenge, with, if I have a good number of people available on Monday, we can meet for about an hour, hour and a half, 2 hours, 5 to 7 for argument's sake. I will send that recording out. So those of you who can't make it can look at the recording, how that sounds.
All right, sir. That's fair because I have class on Monday at five.
That's fine. So at least you still can be a part of the class asynchronously.
Yeah.
All right. So let's go quickly.
If anything, and we don't. If we don't have a session during that time, then you join us. Come over. Yes. Yes, because the whole everything for coming Sunday is going to be very hectic for me because I have work, plus I have my charity that I'm doing on Sunday, which is next week Sunday. So I have to juggle everything right now.
Well, you're busy, man. You're busy. All right. So 2 times 2 plus 1 is 3. So that's 3/2. And then now you're going to have 2 times 5 is 10. 10 plus 4 is 14. So you're going to have 14/5. So you're going to have 3/2 plus 14/5. LCM is 10. So 2 into 10 goes 5 times and 5 times 3 is 15. 5 into 10 goes 2 times and 2 times 14 is 28. 8 and 5 is 13. So this is going to be 43, don't it? 43/10. Somebody talk to me now. 5 plus 10, 14/5.
Yes, sir.
3/2.
All right.
And the LCM is also 10. 5 into 10 goes 2 times. 2 times 14 is 28. 5 into 10 goes 5 times. Clearly not. 2 into 10 goes 5 times and 5 times 3 is 15. 15 minus that is going to be equal to 13/10. And then again, have 43 over 10 multiplied by 10 over 13, don't it? So I get 43 over 13. Anybody get that?
Yes, sir.
What get that?
Yes, sir. That's what I got there.
Okay, good, 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 good. Good. All right. Sounds good. And then last one I'm going to do for today, give you the 15 minutes to go finish off the edit code. Very important, you know, students. We don't read the strips already, you know, in order for you to pass the course. Numerator. 3 sixes are 18 plus 2, 20 over 3. 5 times 2 is 10 plus 1, 11. Oh, minus. Remember, I am going through this, call it almost quickly because we did conversion of those numbers from mixed numbers to improper fraction long time. So I expect you to know. LCM there is 6. 3 into 6 goes 2 times, and 2 times 20 is 40. 2 into 6 goes 3 times, and 3 times 11 is 33. And 40 minus 33 is
7.
Don't.
Yes, yeah. Sir.
Yes, sir.
And then the denominator. Ah! I don't know why I treat you 5 with the denominator. No, 2 over 3 multiplied by 1 over 2. We get 2 over 6, which is 1/3. Don't.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good job. I didn't trick you. Very nice. And then now we have 7 over 6 multiplied by 3 over 1, don't it?
Yes, sir.
7 over 2, or I can say 3 and a half. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Listen to me. You see, anyone who know, go in at the mid-semester or the final exam, remember, I go soon the paper, no? And when I do this, I'm going to shake out in the lunch money to kill. When I can't, not make me feel proud. All right? All right, I'm going to end here for today. The class is not ended, you know. It's just that I want you to use these 15 minutes. Those of you who can, I know some of you will have to go to work. You're still in the framework of class. Log on. Some of you have too many pieces out. The Educos office closing out bits. You want me to do for this one? I think January 3, it's closing out. But remember, you must complete your EDUCASOFT pieces up to where we're supposed to be before the mid-semester exam, or else you're going to be in problems. You cannot do the mid-semester without going through the tutorials and doing the assignment for the EDUCASOFT. You're going to fail. Have a good one. Peace and salutations.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir. Sir. Bye, sir. Sir, remember, I said I want to speak to me.
Chantal, can you call me no on WhatsApp, please?
I don't have the number.
Excuse me, in the WhatsApp group?
No, sir.
Sir, I didn't know, sir, two Chantal have any group. Which one of us?
Two Chantal have another class?
Yes, sir.
Which two?
Yeah, me. I don't know who's other Chantal.
No, sir. Me no not to Chantal. You alone me no Chantal.
So me you want, all right then.
You no want, but there's another Chantal?
No, me is somebody talk about.
No, man, me be a Chantal. No, not Chantal, because Chantal, no Chantal. No, okay. Man.
I don't know. So you can give me a call quick and fast now on the thing. Aleo.
All right. Yes, sir.
You need to get connected to the WhatsApp group, you know. Because clearly not in the WhatsApp group. I mean, if you have a conversation too. Yes, all right. Sir. Good of Bav. Ashantio, I'm gonna call upon you. Can you get Alia's number for me, please? Alia. There's Alia's a friend in another class, you know, because she sent one message here.
Janelle.
Ask Janelle to send the number so we can add it to the group, please.
Okay, sir.
Cool. Later.